What's happening? Facts from the Ghost. Today's segment will detail the battle for Eastern Conference supremacy and advancement to this year's 2000 NBA Finals between the Miami Heat and the Boston Celtics. As you look on the screen, these are the two featured superstars in this series. To your right, Jimmy Butler, who plays for the Miami Heat, and on the left, Jason Tatum, who plays for the Boston Celtics. Now, for most basketball fans who have been watching this year's NBA playoffs, we witnessed simply greatness between these two superstars, and it's glaringly been on display with their play on the court. Jimmy Butler and the Heat ignited this run, earning the eighth seed, and competing against the number one seeded Bucks in the first round. Initially, predictions stated that the Miami Heat would lose the first round series against the Bucks, and then eventually winning this year's 2023 NBA World Championship. You can include me in this prediction because I also thought the Bucks was a heavy favorite to win it all this year. To most basketball fans' surprise, Jimmy Butler and the Miami Heat were able to defeat the Bucks in four games to one, to advance to the second round. The Heat were able to achieve this because Butler averaged a staggering 37.6 points a game, and he also averaged 6 rebounds and 4.8 assists a game. Keep in mind, Giannis, who was projected to be the best player in that series, sustained a contusion to his back that affected his ability to play the first two games of the series. You could say the injury played a significant factor why the Heat won the series, but injuries are a part of the game. Up next for the Heat, the New York Knicks. Now, I'm not going to get into all the stats as to why the Heat were able to defeat the Knicks in 6 games, 4 games to 2, because I will elaborate more on the Miami Heat's organization and the culture of winning they have cultivated over the decades of existence in the NBA at a later time. I will say this, against the Knicks, Butler averaged 24.6 points, and he also averaged 7.2 rebounds and six assists a game, and shot 43.2% from the field. Boston Celtics versus Atlanta Hawks first round, and most know how that story ended. Boston won the series 4 games to 2 in 6 games, with Jason Tatum leading the way with averages of 27.2 points a game, 10 rebounds, and 5 assists. Fast forward to game 7 between the Boston Celtics, Philadelphia 76ers. And because of the explosion of offense dictated by Jason Tatum, scoring 51 points, 25 of those generated in the first half, and later scored 17 in the third and 9 more in the fourth, before exiting the game to a curtain call with 3 minutes and 23 seconds remaining, and Boston lead 108-78. Tatum finished with 51 points, 13 rebounds, and 5 assists, and 2 steals. Again, I'm not going to get into the official stats of the game, but I will say Tatum hit 6 out of 10 3-pointers. May 17th, we will see this epic battle between these two superstars and opposing teams, the Boston Celtics versus the Miami Heat. One more note I would like to add in this year's playoffs, Jimmy Butler is averaging a total in all in points, rebounds, and assists, 10 playoff games, 31.1, 6.6 rebounds, and 5.4 assists. Of course, in this year's 2023 playoffs. Jason Tatum, his stats, of course, for this year's 2003 playoffs, in 10 games, he's averaging 28, 10 rebounds, and 5 assists. Actually, the rebounds are 10.6 and assists are 5.2. So basically for me, how I see this and my prediction for who advances to the NBA Finals, well, let's just say I did the proper calculations, analysts, and breakdowns of who has the advantage in this series. I will give a slight edge to the Celtics, but make no mistake, these two superstars right here, Jason Tatum and Jimmy Butler, will be like a heavyweight boxing match. That's basically my opinion, and for most basketball fans, you and DC are a great series in the making. Thank you for your views. If you like my video, subscribe, but the views I appreciate more. Y'all take care. Y'all stay blessed, you and your families. Stay safe out there. DJ Lottie Dottie, facts from the ghost. One love. Later.